Okay, and this time I'm going to play the Sega compilation while talking about Sega themselves, because I don't understand them. And let me explain why I don't understand them. They get a great history of games, and as you can see, I'm also buying into the emulation things, where they emulate either the arcade games or the Genesis games like this compilation, and I really like them. But my most favorite compilations that they make are on the Nintendo, on the 3DS. All these M2 games, they are awesome. And let me turn down the volume a bit. That's better. So I really like how they do these conversions on the 3DS. You get difficulty settings, you get more extra options. They make a nice humorous animation, which I've also shared on this gaming channel. And they really show the conversions a lot of love. And this is just another compilation game where the only change is you get to select the games in a 3D environment. It looks like an old 80s bedroom where you played your games in the old times. Yeah, it's a nice tribute to the Mega Drive. But most of the games I already knew, because I also got a nice Sonic compilation. They called it Sonic, but also the complete Streets of Rage games are in there and other games. Let's press any button. Let's see where the any button is. Doesn't matter. Just kidding. Well, this is the room. You can just look around in it a bit by selecting things. And as you can see, you got nice old posters of the old games like Golden Axe, Altered Beast, The Revenge of Shinobi, and Streets of Rage. Yeah, let's see the games that they have to offer. Yes, there's the game library. Alex Kidd, Alien Storm. I recently played Alien Storm. It's nice to play this game again. Well, unfortunately, in this case, in all these Mega Drive games, you only get the settings that were on the Mega Drive games. And what I liked about the 3DS games, not only you get the options from the original games, you also get new options to make it either a bit more easy. Games like Power Drift, for instance, the easier you make it, the more lenient the collision detection is, and sometimes you even seem like you're going through the cars without getting penalized for it. And so you can make games that were very hard in the old days much more playable now. And what I like is I always want to see the complete game, to see what the artist has made, what is the next level look like. It's cool. Altered Beast, I was never being able to finish. I never played the Beyond Oasis, I don't know. Biohazard, I don't know. Bonanza Bros, I love that game. That was a very nice animation in there. But I also never really understood how it worked. Columns and Columns 2, puzzle game. Comic Zone, I had, but I also sucked at it. Crackdown, the only Crackdown that I still play today was on the Xbox 360 and now also backwards compatible on the Xbox One X with a 4K patch. So yeah, this Crackdown I don't know. Kneecap Attack, I've heard some good things about it. I never had it back in the time. Mean Bean Machine, I also never had. Dynamite Heady, I know the game but I never had it. Eastward, I had it but I sucked at it. Fatal Labyrinth, I never had it, I don't understand it, what it is. I never looked it up on the internet as well. Flicky, yeah, I've seen it on that YouTube channel with Dave and, what's it called? Oh yeah, GameSack, yes. Game Ground was also on GameSack, so it's nice to, I'm going to try out this game. Galaxy Force 2, how can they give us Galaxy Force on the Mega Drive that can't even come close to what they have to offer on the 3DS. Now that is the arcade version and better. And now you get to play the Mega Drive version. I'm not even going to try it out. Golden Axe, that was a great conversion on the Mega Drive. And it's nice to finally have part 2 and part 3. I will try them out. I haven't tried it out yet. Gunstar Heroes. I've already got this on the 3DS, so you can make it a bit more easy. Since these all these running gun shooters. Let's start from the beginning. Kid Chameleon, I don't know. Landstalker, I don't know. Light Crusader, I don't know. Fantasy Star, that's not my type of games. Rise Star, haven't checked it out. Shadow Dancer, I loved back in the days. I loved how that worked with the dog. I even like this, like Mega Drive exclusive, more than the game with the dog in the arcades. That Shinobi 2, or I don't know what it's called. This one I like even better. Shining in the Darkness, never heard of it. Shining Force, I never had it. This Shinobi game, part 3, that was amazing. I had it, but I couldn't come that far. Of course, who doesn't know the Sonic games? Sonic 3D Blast, I never had. But the best Sonic game is in there. My favorite Sonic game ever is Sonic 2. Sonic 1 started it all. I still appreciate for what it is. I can finish the game and I'm not missing out that Spin Dash that much. But yes, it's true. For a game based on speed, there are a lot of slow sections in this game. And since Sonic 1 needs a very long time to finally get up to speed, it doesn't feel right playing this game slowly. So yeah, there are a few parts in the game, design-wise, that they could have done that better. And they did with Sonic 2. I never played this one, so I will give it a try. Sonic Spinball, I bought it back in the days. And it felt weird that you were able to not only shoot Sonic as a ball, but you could even control him. So it's even more easy than a normal pinball game, because after you launched the ball, or after you flipped it away with one of the flippers, you could aim it a bit into the direction you wanted it to go. Space Harrier 2. I've bought it also at the time that I bought my Mega Drive. But the reason for me to buy me a Mega Drive was I was walking in front of a shop and I saw Ghouls and Ghosts. I saw a running demo in the windows of the shop, and they hide the Mega Drive away. So all you see was a screen demoing the game. And I was like, at that time, it was a long time ago that I saw the arcade version, so to my eyes it looked like arcade perfect. So I walked into the store and I said, how did you manage to hook up an arcade board onto a normal television? And he was like, that isn't the arcade board, it's the Sega Mega Drive. So I went home, and the next weekend when I got me some money, I returned to the game shop buying the Mega Drive, Ghouls and Ghosts, and Space Harrier 2. And I also had Super Hang-On. Oh yeah. The Streets of Rage series, still amazing. Super Thunderblade, not so. That was just a big letdown. Sword of Vermillion, I never had. Revenge of Shinobi, I also had it. Also, that game was very difficult to me. Toe Jam and Earl, that game didn't speak to me. I don't like the design. It's not really my thing. That seems to be a more platform-based game. I never had it, but I will be trying it out. Oh, and then we got Vector Man. That looks awesome. And it's nice that we have part 2 in there as well. Virtua Fighter, a 2D game based on a 3D game. I really wonder how that will work. In a 3D environment, I didn't mind the slowness. So if they make this game try to play as the 3D version, for me it wouldn't work, because a 2D based game with sprites supposed to have a nice and quick response, just like with the Street Fighter games or the Mortal Kombat games. So I'm curious, I will be trying this one out. Wonder Boy 3, Monster's Lair. I was never into the Wonder Boys except for the very first one that I played on the Commodore 64. And Wonder Boy in Monster World, I don't know that one as well. So, what game shall I play for this video? You know what? We're going to have a laugh. We're going to play a game that the Mega Drive just isn't capable of. And I don't know if I already started it up. But if my memory serves me well, either I played it only once and then turned it off laughing, or or I saw it on YouTube. Yeah, I watch much old school games and it's nice. But also what I don't understand from Sega is, oh, let's see if I can make it a bit easier. Easy. Shield, strong, weak. Oh, there's only strong. Game difficulty. Oh, you can. Oh, that's nice. You can easy. Direction, normal or reverse. Well, just normal. So let's continue. What I don't understand is if they release these games very nice on the 3DS. Games like Turbo Outrun, for instance, was released in Japan. But was it released in America? Was it released in Europe? No. Somehow Sega don't want to make money off their fans in Europe, and they don't want to make money off their fans in America. What the heck? I don't understand. Never mind. This is something that, well, let's try by just playing with. I forgot to check what the speed was. Oh, I hear very soft. Oh, this is rewind or something? Or forward? No, that's strange. I don't know if you can actually change the speed. Well, the sprites are kind of crude. It works, but the game is really slow. Can I go faster or something? Or I don't know. Eh? What was that? That huge spaceship that you fight and now you got it like... It's like... What the? Yeah, of course, the Mega Drive can't cope with this. I wonder how the inside of the planet will look like. I think all just flat sprites and not zoomed in, of course, because the Mega Drive can't do scaling. All these sprites are redrawn time after time again. Flying turds, or was it chocolate chip cookies that I was just passing? The game looks rather empty compared to the 3DS version and PlayStation 2 version. Of course, I didn't expect the Mega Drive to actually come close to the original. Sure. The music is very soft. The sound is very soft. All these games are very loud. When you started the intro, I had to turn down the volume. Oh, eh? The controls, when I use the either, oh, let's see if you can play with the D-pad. Yes, you can. It responds so slow. Well, at least they try to create some sprites of the arcade. But we have an interior with the exit that is running away from us. Yes, I know the arcade version had this too. But it was much further away. And it's not even sprites. This looks like the floor of Space Harrier, but except for, oh no, the Buck Rogers game on the, even on the Commodore 64 it was. I can see how they tried it, like with this big square, they make it look like the hallway is getting more narrow. Left turn. Yeah, I didn't find the speed control things, but let's just skip this one. This is just... It's a game that was never... Hold to exit. Thank you. And then back. Game library. I want to play another game, but... Now one that is not so ridiculous, and I saw this game at GameSec, and that looked kind of fun. And for a Mega Drive, I must say the animation is rather smooth. All these Mega Drive games have low sound, so let's turn it back up. This is just a demonstration. Well, this looks like a regular platformer, but some platforms are not so easy to see. They are kind of out of sight. Well, let's give it a go. I might suck at this because I never played it. Somewhere in outer space. So no difficulty settings, just like Sonic. So they better have a good gameplay mechanic in there. Funkotron, okay. Yeah, this game's supposed to be watched on a smaller TV. So yeah, the 16-bit graphics are a bit chunky here. Still Earthlings. Making an awful mess. Outside of a returning spaceship. But to be honest, the sound in this game is twingy, and I can understand why a lot of people would say that on a VART the Super Nintendo had better sound, because well, this is sounding rather thin, and I don't know if it's the emulation of the sound that's being bad or the game really had that grating twingy sound. But the animation is very nice, and I must say sprite design is good. Yeah, I wonder if I can skip this. Yes, you can. Play. Let's give it a go with just two of them. I don't know if you need to play this with two characters. Yes, you have. Thank you. So then I have to return. No? How does this work? Oh yeah, keep holding this button. I made a mistake. So I need to select a new game now. Oh no, I can just reselect the game and then it will start. Let's try to skip all this now. No. Play. So I can only play. Oh, I prefer him then. Well, no, let's pick Earl. Oh, the jump button is B. Now that's a strange button. Well, maybe I picked the wrong character, because it actually hold up to shake trees or pushes for buttons. Ah, so yeah, I missed my present, I guess. Oh, you can't push it. Well, I like the scrolling effect. Press start to get menu for Funk Scan Panic button or Funk Vac. Yeah, I kind of forgot that you can throw things as well. Huh? Oh. Yeah, I don't know, but... Can't I hit him? Oh, it, obviously I can't. Oh, looks like I have to hit the Earthling. I don't. Yeah. Game tip: hide from someone. Hold down any button to pass through things. Oh. Looks like the question is what to catch and what not to catch. What this you don't catch. Jump higher by jumping from a squatting position. Okay. Blue flex mark by your return after you lose a life. Oh! Well, danger sign meaning all heavy stuff comes out of the trees. Looks like. To look in manhole, stand on one side and squat down. Use the direction pad and the jump button. Okay. I don't understand, but it's nice. Oh, it looks like I died. Looks like we have to go here. But the question is, where? Oh, I can see a time running down. I guess I have to. No, get back up. Maybe I need to go just here. No. But it looks like I can't go anywhere. A platform gamer and I'm stuck. Yeah. Oh, present. Oh, secret. More secret. Oh. Looks like these animals can't hurt you. I need air. Yeah, you know what? I've seen this enough. I mean, yeah. Well, to be honest, I would prefer to play the games that I used to play on the Mega Drive, because the games that I never had, I don't have a feel for it. So, it to me, it's amazing that YouTubers like GameSack, they even play games that they never owned back in the times, but they collect all the games for a system or for several systems, and they just can play the games and have fun with them. And I must say that some games, the play mechanics doesn't do anything for me, and so yeah, I'm not having too much fun playing them. So to be honest, of this whole collection, let me tell you what games I like, and then I will end the video. Alex Kidd can be fun. I don't know for sure, but if it's something like that I played on the Commodore 64, then it might be fun. Alien Soldier, don't know. I don't know the game. Alien Storm is fun. It's a bit difficult, but I like the part where you enter a warehouse and then shoot things, and by breaking things you can unlock extras like ammunition, strength. Altered Beast, I don't hate it as much as other people do, but I don't like it as well. So it's avarts at best. Sorry, my bad. Beyond Oasis, I don't know, so I don't have an opinion. Bonanza Brothers is a great game, especially when it comes to the animation. I like puzzle games, so I think Columns will be my cup of tea. Comics Zone is technically impressive. Graphically, design-wise, it's awesome. But it's very difficult, so yeah, I wouldn't play it too much. Crackdown, I don't know. Let's go to another game that I know. Well, we just tried this, and the sooner we forget about it, the better. Golden Axe was a great conversion of the arcade game. Yeah, there were some differences in design, but still a great game nonetheless. Gunstar Heroes is an excellent game. Difficult, but excellent. Well, the game I just recently played, the Toads of an Early Panic on Funktron, well, it looks very nice, but yeah, too complex for me. A platform game should be a bit more straightforward than that. And in Sonic, it's more easy to find your way to through the levels. I don't know this one. Super Thunder Blade, it plays reasonably, but nah, it's too clunky and too un-arcade-like, so I don't have a fit. Even back in the time, because I bought this game as well, because I kind of expected something like what they did with Outrun. So not the graphics perfectly matching, but at least capturing the feel. But it feels too clunky to even capture the feel of the original game. The Streets of Rage series, they started out good. Then the best ever street fighting clone game ever arrives with Streets of Rage 2. And Streets of Rage 3, I like some extras, like the way that you don't empty your life bar on the special, but if you use it up, extra bar fills up, and when it's full you can use the extra move. So that's good, but the music has went down. That was just bad to my taste. And the characters, designs and colors, they were less popping than Streets of Rage 2. Not a bad game, but definitely it pales in comparison to Streets of Rage 2. For me, this is my opinion, and of course, yeah, opinions are like assholes, everybody's got them. Okay, well, Space Harrier 2, even though it doesn't have that sprite scaling effect, it was still rather fun to play back in the time. I haven't played it right now, but Sonic Spinball was fun. This one I never had, so I have to try it out. Sonic and Sonic 2, they are just great games. Shinobi 3 is a great game. I like it. Shadow Dancer, awesome. That's my favorite Shinobi game. These two, I know they are technically very impressive with nice graphics effects in the 2D animations and so. I'm looking forward to play these games. I can't comment on this one, but I expect nothing but the same as with Galaxy Force. Wonder Boy, those two, they can be fun. Okay. So, yes, I've bought it to support Sega, but most of the games I already own in one form or another, also connected on a proper way to my television so you can play it on a big screen. So, this compilation doesn't hold too much value for me, but I do like the presentation. And if you don't own a compilation, it's even more of value to you than it is for me, because, well, if you got that Sonic collection on the 3D on the Xbox 360, then yeah, then that's a better compilation to my likings, because there are also arcade games that you can unlock. For instance, Space Harrier, but now, unlike in Shenmue, with Space Harrier you can continue where you left off if you insert the coins. So, this is a nice tribute to a great console in the 16-bit era. But yeah, there have been bigger and better compilations, and I kind of hoped that you could fill the rest of the cabinet with like DLC, and that you gain some other Mega Drive games that weren't made available in compilations thousands of times already. Okay, well, I hope you have fun watching the video, and Sega, if you're listening, bring us Turbo Outrun. Even, and now I hear you are making these old games for the Nintendo Switch. Why are you skipping the Xbox One and the PlayStation 4? Why not make more money by selling all your nice compilations on every system like you do with this one? Why not make those great M2 backwards compatible, or emulation games, make them available on the other consoles as well? Because those on the 3DS, those are my most favorite games to play. When I have a nostalgic feel, I'll just pick up my 3DS, play some OutRun, Super Hang-On, or whatever you've released in Europe, because, well, I can't play what you deny us to play. Yeah, this is also something that I don't understand. I've been a Sega friend a long time, but some decisions, yeah, they are just rather curious, to say the least. Thanks for watching, and have a nice day.